Journalist Kirsten disparaged by suspended lawyer and senatorial candidate Lorenzo Larry Gadon in a viral video has hit back. On Friday, investigative journalist and award-winning book author Raisa Robles filed complaints for violation of the Safe Spaces Act, cyber libel, and libel against Gadon before the Quezon City Prosecutor's Office. Robles accused Gadon of uttering terrorizing, unwanted sexual, misogynistic, and sexist statements in the profanity-laden video, which she says can be considered gender-based online sexual harassment. In a subsequent Facebook video, Gadon supposedly accused her of spreading fake news. To talk more about the complaints, we are joined on the line this morning by Ms. Raisa Robles, senior Manila correspondent of the South China Morning Post and author of the book Martial Law, Never Again. Also joining us is her lawyer, Attorney Sandra Olaso-Fignel, senior lecturer at the UP College of Law and partner of the Yonac Sarmiento Law Firm, where she heads the litigation department. Good morning, Ms. Raisa and Attorney Coronel. Thank you for your time. Mike?
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you, Attorney Coronel. I know you are going to a hearing right now, but thanks for taking our call. And Raisa, thank you also. Let me start with you, Attorney Coronel. These are three complaints that Ms. Robles filed. Why these cases and what are the basis for this?
Well, yes, because of the video. Whatever he said in the video will be the basis of the complaint. There are two videos that are the subject of the complaint. The first is the viral video of him commenting, well, making misogynistic remarks against Raisa, and that is the basis for the Safe Spaces Act. And then his subsequent interview where he supposedly apologized, but actually did not apologize to Raisa and instead accused her of being a purveyor of fake news, that is the subject of our cyber libel and our libel complaint.
Mm-hmm. And we're talking about a jail term of how many years or months, Attorney Coronel?
Well, I can't really say how much time he will be given by the court, but yes, this is a criminal complaint, so may kulong dito sa reklamong ito.
Mm-hmm. Let me go to Raisa. Raisa, what prompted you to file these complaints?
I think what he did was too much, recently, I keep getting these Facebook direct messages, unwanted direct messages, telling me that I deserved what Gadon did to me. I think that no woman who wants to do political discourse in the internet deserves that kind of treatment ever.
Mm-hmm. And Raisa, I note that journalists normally object to the use of libel and cyber libel against journalists. In your complaint, you are still for decriminalization of libel and cyber libel, but you said you were forced to stop a new wave of vicious verbal sexual attacks. But where do you draw the line between using libel as a weapon on the one hand and as a shield to protect your reputation?
You know, it's a very thin line, and I know that I am treading on, you know, ground that very few reporters have tread into. But the case of Gadon is exceptional. I believe that looking at what he had said to me and looking what he keeps saying about me, I believe that libel and cyber libel were the other two cases that needed to be filed in this case.
Mm-hmm. Attorney Coronel, Attorney Gadon has raised the issue that the video, the first video at least, was supposedly private and was made only for Ms. Robles, and that what happened was purely personal between them. Will this defense fly, assuming you only rely on libel and cyber libel?
Well, no, because the Safe Spaces Act covers all kinds of communication, whether it is public or private, because this does not require a publication in the sense of cyber libel or libel. Mm-hmm. What it requires is the utterance of such derogatory words to women that makes them feel very unsafe, especially in the online world.
Mm-hmm. And how significant is it that Gadon himself has apologized? Well, as you said, he didn't actually apologize. He apologized to women offended by his statements. Will this have any bearing on the complaints? And will this serve as a further proof that he admitted he said what he said?
Well, that's how we see it. he did not deny having said it. Not that he could, because he is in the video. It's undeniable that it's him in the video, and the words are undeniable. But, you know, that the supposed apology was actually a non-apology. He was actually just pandering to his supporters and to his family when he gave that video out and his interview. He was not really apologetic for what he said to Raisa and about Raisa's mother, for example, and all the vile words that he used against her.
Mm-hmm. Raisa, you said in your complaint you believe Gadon's outburst was politically motivated. Why do you think so?
Because I found out, after I filed the complaint also, and before that, there was something suspicious about his utterances about the certification from the BIR. And then it has turned out that in his interview with, who's that, Attorney Sandy? Who?
Bitangkol?
The MRT guy? Bitangkol, yes.
Bitangkol. Yes.
It turned out that Gadon was the one who approached the BIR for the certification of for Bongbong Marcos taxes. And so, and also, after having said all of those filthy things online, he still was fielded as an official candidate of the Team Unity Party. Mm-hmm. So I think Gadon is going to be used as a political weapon by the Marcos camp in these elections.
And let's just remind our viewers, Raisa, that you're also the author of the Never Again, Marcos Martial Law Never Again book that is being actually cited by some anti-Marcos proponents as basis for the claims of, you know, as basis for martial law atrocities and other things that happened during martial law.
Yes, and people, I would like to tell people that when the book first came out, I personally delivered a copy of that book to the office of Senator Bongbong Marcos at that time. And then later on, I asked him if he had read it, and he said he thanked me for giving him the book. And he told me, I'm sorry, I haven't read it because I've been too busy.
Now, very quickly, go ahead.
He knows all about the atrocities. He knows all about the hidden wealth.
Mm-hmm. Now, lastly, Attorney Coronel and Raisa, what message are you trying to send by pushing for these complaints against Gadon?
Attorney Coronel.
Well, you know, this is a good opportunity for us to test the Safe Spaces Act. It is a policy of the state to protect everybody in the online world, that you cannot use online communication for purposes of undermining, terrorizing, or even threatening other people. And especially, you know, Raisa, she's not too young. She carries a senior citizen card. So it is actually qualified that somebody is using the internet for purposes of these things, you know? And we should not let it happen. And that's the reason why Raisa has come out to file this case.
Mm-hmm. Raisa?
You know, Mike, I said I would sue him, and so I have. And everything is there in the document my lawyer and I filed. You know, the country just held the bar exam. And It's sickening to imagine Gadon as an example of what a lawyer is to those who took the exam. He is a terrible example, a terrible human being. As for Gadon himself, let me ask him, is that the mouth you kiss your mother with? The same mouth that you poured such filthy language at me?
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Raisa Robles and Attorney Sandra Coronel.
Thank you.